and welcome to CETV, where I'm here with Hilary Beaven-Jones, who's chair of Water Sprite Film Festival and former chair of BAFTA. The television industry is facing ever-increasing competition from online streaming services such as Netflix and Amazon, who provide on-demand programmes for a much longer period of time than BBC iPlayer. What do you think the television industry should do to try and maintain higher viewing figures?
I think that competition is healthy. And I think that the fact that there are now more platforms doesn't actually mean that everybody should start trying to provide the same thing. Mm-hmm. Not everybody wants a Netflix show. Not everyone wants a traditional terrestrial show. And let's actually embrace all the different opportunities that there are. We're just making a show for Fox Network Group, which is Africa and Europe, and that. We're at their first drama. So although it's competitive, I think that's a good thing. And there's more than enough writers and producers and actors to make shows for all these different opportunities.
So again, with the increase in competition, do you think that script development process in TV industry has changed? And has it changed to claw back viewers?
The script development process has changed a bit in the UK in a number of ways, but essentially it's always got the same goal, which is making and telling the best story possible, because without a good script, whoever you're making it for, it's not going to fly. One of the things that's changed is there's a slight move towards the American development style, which is where you have a showrunner and the showrunner drives the development process, and you have a writer's room with lots of writers contributing to the series. Mm-hmm. Where they work in different ways, sometimes they're allocated different scripts, sometimes you what's called break the story in the room. And for example, in our office at the moment, big room covered in stickies for each episode of a series with the character names in different colours and how they all mesh together. The stories are done collectively, and then different writers are assigned different stories, but they've all contributed to each episode. No one is one piece of work. The key thing, whether you're writing in the more traditional manner of a one writer alone in a room or a group, the really key thing is you need one leader, you need one author at the top. Mm-hmm. But I don't so much see it as competition. I see it as a sort of blossoming, and people that didn't used to want to be in television are fighting to get into television now. Film producers who've only made films are trying to cross over because television has suddenly got more money. People are prepared to spend. I mean, Andy Harries, who produces The Crown, he said his budgets for each episode of The Crown are more than most feature film, lower budget feature mm-hmm. films, not blockbusters, obviously. So it's a really exciting period, and it doesn't mean you don't have to have a budget the size of The Crown in order to produce good drama. The budget needs to be commensurate with the scale of the production mm-hmm. and the needs of the production. Yeah. And as long as those two things match, then you're fine. That's the challenge.
Thank you. And also, the BBC recently created a Sherlock Live event where the viewers were able to use their knowledge of what problem-solving skills and deduction skills to solve an online Sherlock mystery. And how do you think the TV will become more interactive in the future and increase audience participation?
I think that audience participation is growing all the time. We've been doing experiments on a William Boyd project that I'm involved in, about virtual reality and whether we can tell these stories using virtual reality. So we all had a hysterical session wearing weird glasses and with William Boyd working out if he's going to jump off a skyscraper or not. I couldn't even put the glasses on. I was a complete sissy. So I think that there's lots of new options. There's new options for lengths of programming, and it's basically an exciting time.
So what do you think the importance of small festivals such as Water Sprite are on the TV and film industry?
Well, Water Sprite, which is the Cambridge International Student Film Festival, is now in its eighth year. I think it's really important. Not just for Cambridge, but also we have students who have made short films in from all over the world to celebrate and to have their short films seen. It celebrates diversity. It gives these students that come in a chance to meet with fellow filmmakers, to tell their stories, to learn about other cultures. We have had entries from over 80 countries, and we've welcomed people from Nepal, from Myanmar, from Russia, from Denmark, so many places. And we see, and the importance for the filming industry is that alliances are made, and you see people from different countries connect, and then they go forward to make a film together. In one instance, it went on to be Oscar nominated, and it was two students who had met at Cambridge. And so Cambridge, as ever, as a centre of excellence, is providing this opportunity. And the key thing about Water Sprite Festival, which I've chaired for the 8 years that it's run, is that the day-to-day, the running of it is by Cambridge students. Mm-hmm. So the students themselves get involved in the process, and they learn a huge amount about running a festival. And it attracts a diverse audience of Cambridge and people from wider afield, as well as showing films from that as well. So it's a proper celebration of diversity.